is dancing for you.
I'm doing the bachata.
The who?
The Spanish bachata.
Is that with garlic or without?
What do you like?
I used to call salsa dancing quite a lot. I met you and I stopped.
Oh god!
I only had one drink, I promise.
Right, good evening everybody. We've got 20 people watching so far, so we're going to wait for the numbers to come up. I think you've got to guess what tonight's going to be. From that. Oh, hang on, look. Oh, they don't have to guess, do they? You've told them in the...
Well, ish, kind
of. Well...
I've set up my...
So what we got? Some of these.
I'm doing like a fancy little fries.
Alright, can I try one?
Yeah,
oh, yummy.
They're like matchstick fries, this is how you call them. And I actually used my mandolin correctly this time. They have a guard and everything.
Right.
Good,
so, whilst we're waiting for the numbers to get up, I just want to show you an absolutely lovely gift that we were lucky enough to receive today from my lovely neighbour Ian and Michelle. Look at that, it's a gin tree. Because you know, the person commenting saying Ian and Michelle live opposite us and we give them any excess food, or not excess food, or when you make it too much for us. Yeah, any excess food.
It's a care package.
Yeah, care package. And so they've done me this, so I'm going to make myself a gin and tonic. Whilst one-handed gin and tonic.
Can you tell who Ian is?
Sorry?
What's the imperfection?
Is it a 3-second pour? That doesn't really work like that, does it? Is that
Ian
too much?
Ian is blacksmith, isn't he?
Yeah, Ian, but we'll pop the link on to where Ian in fact sells these. But I don't think that's what he was meant for when he gave it to me, but I said we'll put it on our live anyway. Right, so.
And,
right, yeah. you got 51 people watching now,
and
darling.
Even
so.
Talking about the neighborhood spirit, I do wanna.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna show them,
you're
darling.
Show that.
Yeah.
Okay.
So. Oh, right.
No, do that.
No, all right, now go on.
Do
you,
the
now, you now, go on, please.
Okay, so look, guys. So from dough I made this lovely little creature. That's our Italian bread, cashew. So that dough, which I'm knotted with you, or made with you, and I let it rest, and I put it in the fridge today. I took it out.
So this is that's the dough you made for the pizzas,
yeah,
yesterday.
Absolutely.
You've turned it into the bread for breaking bread for tonight.
Yeah. How cool is that? So if you are feeling like you don't feel that you want to go to the shop, and you have yeast, you have flour, two fingers to make a knot, olive oil, a rosemary and a sea salt. And how did it taste today? You've tried it.
Oh, I need to add a little nibble.
You had already nibble.
Nom 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 nom. Nom. Right, so, what are we making this evening? Again?
Guys, you saw I received a whole care package from a fishmonger
with a hiccup.
A fishmonger-ish. The products were frozen, but it's still an opportunity and an option for someone like me. I'm making matchstick fries. I made my own frying station here.
So what sort of potatoes are they, darling?
The red ones. It's a Mary's pie.
Is that, are they red?
Or King Edward.
You don't know, do you?
The red skin potatoes I'm using. The red skin potatoes have been always advised for deep fat frying are the best ones.
Do you know Laura Green?
Wait.
Laura Green went, go Olga, heart!
Thank you. So, in my deep fat frying station, homemade deep frying station.
I've got a, can we just go on to just saying what a massive, massive, huge, mongous, mega thank you for everybody who has clicked the share button.
Wow,
most shares we've ever had on Olga's Quarantine Kitchen.
And you know what?
10,000 views overnight.
Yeah, I know. I was like, he woke me up and said like, you know how many people watched your video? So I'm like, go on, because I usually say, why did you wake me up?
And that's all down to you guys.
You wake up before me, and I'm usually the one who goes to bed after you. So I'm...
Cheers, Ian.
So yeah, I mean, like, and I even didn't get angry because it was like, oh my god, 10,000 people watched me cook. You know, just like ordinary person, exactly the same as you are.
Well, but... not quite, darling. You're a little bit special.
Yeah, right. He's taking the mickey now. So look, what I did...
Nothing wrong with special, darling.
What I did, I fried them a couple of times. So cool them down, fry them again. Cool them down, fry them again. So they're almost like a macaroni fries. I used my mandolin correctly this time when I cut my potatoes. So we... And,
so where is the potato? Let me show them which ones they are.
I might have one. Hold on. If you stir that, I'll cook it.
Oh, I've got to stir this. How do I do that?
Just stir it. The red potato.
Aha. So that's the potato. That makes a better chip, does
it? Yeah. Because they are starchy, I think. And that's why how they hold themselves together nicely. So that's... I cooked them 3 times and I'm quite happy with how they are.
So this is a garlic...
I'm going to make a garlicky potatoes with my clams.
So is there any garlic in it yet?
No. I'm just trying them. You naughty.
Oh, come on.
Okay, next bit what we're going to do, guys. I'm still going to use this oil, so don't throw it away.
No, that's the same oil you used the other day, wasn't it?
Yeah. Oh, it's gonna be very, 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 very expensive. In my deep pan, clove butter.
So, what's you doing in this one?
I'm gonna make a sauce for my clams.
Sauce for the clams?
Yeah. Butter, onion, oil. I think I'm gonna need to reduce this here. Because butter is burning, as you can see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Clams and doors for the parrot.
So
right,
we've got onion.
So this is butter, olive oil,
onion, garlic.
How much garlic?
Okay, 2 cloves.
2 cloves.
Then yeah.
I'm gonna
stick. Fennel. 1 clove of fennel, a large one.
1 clove?
Like a bulb.
Oh, right. Okay. And what is this for, this bit?
I'm going to make a clam sauce.
Ah, right, yeah, yeah.
That's
yeah.
The base for our fishy, delicious sauce.
Right.
I'm going to... Cool. I've reduced the heat now. And now we're going to go and do our salad, yeah?
Yeah.
In my salad, so I pre-cooked octopus. I'm just keeping it warm.
So you pre-cooked this octopus?
Just boiled octopus for 1 hour. Yeah.
You boiled it for 1 hour?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. And then I boiled this in the octopus water.
So you boiled those potatoes in the water that the octopus was in?
That's it. Nothing else.
Right.
No. Nothing extra water to add, nothing else to add. So basically, you boil octopus with 3 bay leaves, salt and pepper, and then once you've drained octopus, keep it warm, and then you boil potatoes in the same water octopus been boiled at.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, sounds nothing nice. Else. It's nothing extra water, nothing to add. Very, very simple way. Octopus is quite eccentric
eccentric.
Yeah, it is. You know, it's a bit controversial as well, because Aluka now was like, oh, do I fancy eating them? You are so tasty, I'm not sure if I want to eat you. I love it. I love them. What are we going to do next, guys? With our potatoes. Because now they've dried out and now they're ready. I'm going to take one off. In a quite chunky way.
Evening Sam, evening Laura, evening Richard, evening Caroline.
Evening everyone, how are you?
When you come on, say hello. The more comments, the better. Make sure they're nice and polite. If they're not, you get deleted, blocked.
Don't be so aggressive today.
Well, I'm just saying, only nice comments. Oh, darling, did you go out and do the clap tonight? Hey, for the chorus.
No,
nah,
we missed it.
Oh.
The other people don't.
Did you hear it?
No. I really hope our Prime Minister as well.
Yeah, so do I. Just shows you how it
you know, it's
it
not,
doesn't,
no.
Doesn't care who
exactly.
It is.
Exactly. No.
Anyway.
No discrimination when it comes to.
Yeah. So what are these potatoes for? You just...
Just for the salad. That's how I'm being a bit...
Yeah, nickety.
Yeah.
And again, for all the people who have just joined, thank you so, so, so much for clicking the share button. That is the ultimate gift for us. We had 10,000 views last night from just you guys clicking the share button. You can make this happen for Olga. Good evening, Mark. Good evening, Lisa. Lisa shared. I know, I saw you. Fantastic. Thank you so much, Lisa, for those shares.
So when you do make your octopus, because I had them frozen.
Rachel from three doors down saying hello. Oh, there you got a kiss, Rachel.
Can you show what some of them three doors down did?
Talking about three doors down.
A community spirit.
Yeah, so I've hit the number. We got this through self-isolation. My name is Lauren and I live at number 45. If you need anything in this difficult time, please give me a shout. And her phone number's the other side of there. I'm not going to put that live, but how lovely.
That's a community spirit.
Yeah,
that will help us to get through this difficult time.
Well, I just said, you know,
things like that.
I was going to give her a call and say the windows need a bit of a clean.
Yeah.
What? Come on.
So look, that's anyone can do. So basically, boil the potato, boil the octopus, yeah?
Yeah.
Place it on the plate in this quirky manner.
Sporadic.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What we're going to do next, we are, in here, we have olive oil with garlic.
Right, hold on. Sorry, we're eating some things.
Olive with mashed up garlic.
Right.
And I'm going to squeeze a bit of lemon.
Oh, wow. Laura shared to three groups.
Oh, my goodness.
Mark says hi.
I'm going to
Harvey.
Parsley in as well. This can't be easier, you know, guys. It's so simple.
Look at them hearts coming in. I wonder if they're from Mark.
So I'm gonna.
How many of you guys that are watching have done the voluntary NHS? I know Mark did. Well done, Mark.
So parsley, garlic, lemon juice. Just like this. So simple, but so effective with flavors. That's something I've tried in Spain. I used to, before I met Matt, I used to go scuba diving.
Darling, you, before you met Matt, there wasn't a life. Come on. She's not commenting on
I
that.
I used to go diving in the caves. Deep cave diving. Scuba diving. and black corals are located in Mallorca, and this is the dish inspired from, because this is a area where lots of squid is. So you just sprinkle a bit of a smoky paprika. Do you want to smell it? Spanish smoky paprika. Can you smell it?
I'm not.
Does it smell? Whoa. Can you smell it?
Yeah, it just smells like bonfires.
Exactly. This is exactly how it's meant to smell. Lovely? Do you like it?
Dora Webb, is that Dora Webb?
Dory Webb.
Dory Webb.
Hi, Dory!
Oh, hi, hello. Oh, cool. You did well, Dory.
Okay. So what do we have here? So we have our matchstick fries.
No, I've got to eat some. I've got to test them.
Matchstick fries.
Oh, they're good. Oh, they're good. Oh, they're good. Yeah, they're good. They're naughty.
And they're quite thin. And I'm frying my fennel, garlic, and onion in here.
This is for your...
sauce for my clams. Ah! Oh, Matthew. You are
blind. Sauce for the clams.
I'm going to increase heat now, so I can control it. Yeah, but look at the salad, though. Who wouldn't like that salad? It's so, so simple to make, but it looks so fancy, doesn't it? So when you do have octopus...
It doesn't really look like a salad though, does it?
It is an octopus, warm octopus and potato salad.
Warm octopus, well, so what makes it a salad then?
That's how it's called, that's the Spanish way. Right?
So to me, that doesn't look like a salad.
I think you need to take pictures of that.
Okay.
I'm going to put it in my cooking section for my studies when I'm back to school, because I'm an apprentice.
Alright, there we go.
So I think my tutor would be quite pleased with me.
He watches it, doesn't he?
I don't know, not always. So pass your breath.
Oops, now I got a big old shadow.
Sorry. Right?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get some
what
pictures
for you. What do you think about the focaccia bread?
You want me to tell you live?
Yeah.
That's a bit tough. Did you want me to say that?
It's bread though.
Yeah, it's not. It's
butter.
Not amazing.
You need some butter on this, don't you?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna, on that note, butter, frying pan, in there.
In the frying pan, right?
Yeah.
What's this for?
For my garlic fries.
So
this
fennel, is the garlic fries.
Yeah. Fennel, you can see it's caramelized on the sides, garlic and onion. What I'm going to do next.
And that's, you've told everyone enough times. Things for me, forget.
White wine.
You got to get your white wine in, didn't you? You love putting a bit of wine in, didn't you?
You have to put it, it brings all the flavors up. Pinch of salt.
That wasn't a pinch, that was a shovelful.
Stop complaining. So, pepper.
Mark French cooked steak and barbecue tonight with a homemade potato wedges and peppercorn sauce.
Did you use my recipe for the peppercorn sauce? I hope you did.
Yeah, do you know what? Yeah. We saw someone the other day. Well, I didn't see them. They phoned me up to say that they were using the peppercorn sauce for their barbecue.
Made my day.
It did.
I went, oh my god, that's so cool. Someone actually utilized the skills I have. You know what I always say?
Labas.
Labas vakaras. Labas vakaras. That's in Lithuanian, you should know by now.
Oh, what's that? Hello.
Good evening.
Good evening.
He is not very good in Lithuanian at all.
I'm not very good in anything else than bad English.
So we're doing our butter. So fennel.
Oh.
Butter is frying. I'm going to add some oil to stop it from...
Lisa French said that she actually made the wedges. Mark forgot to add that.
So they obviously like us. Competitive. Nothing wrong with
it. Well, no, I'm not going to try and compete with you when it comes to cooking.
He did curtains tonight, today. Cut the curtains, ironed them up, so folded them in. Put them up on the wall.
I shortened the curtains, yeah.
And you put them up on the...
Yeah, put up curtain poles.
I was well impressed with that.
And the pleats, hung them, put the tie backs on.
Everything, yeah.
So I earned my gin.
So I'm happy with that. I'm going to add cream. There was a glass of white wine and a glass of cream. Shellfish. Is it the shellfish or how would you say it? Mollusks.
Shellfish?
No, that's not shellfish, that's mollusks.
Which?
They're mollusks. Not shellfish. Clams.
Your clams? I don't know.
So if they would be raw, I would put them in oil first, and those which would be closed, I would discard them, but because they're pre-cooked and that's what I was able to get, I'm grateful for what I have. I'm just gonna pop them in after I added the cream. In a normal life situation, you would add white wine and then you put your cocoas in. Then you take them out and discard those which are closed, and then you would add your cream, and then again you would mix your cocoas. Okay? You feel me? But that's what I have. I have pre-cooked ones, so I'm going to use the pre-cooked ones.
Read that.
Martin Olga, please say goodnight to Asa May. She loves watching Olga cook. Good night, my darling. Sweet dreams. That is so sweet. You know what? Things that have made my evening, I feel like, you know, I prepare, I read the books, I look through the thousand and thousand recipes before we decide what I'm going to cook. It doesn't just happen, and you know, I sometimes feel like, oh, do I need to do that? Should I be doing this? And you know, people text things like that and you're like, yes, I should. So, you see, I melted my butter, I melted my garlic. So all those...
Sharon, I can't show you the curtains this evening. Unfortunately, I've got the gun safe open, and because I'm doing my renewing my firearm certificate, my guns are out having their serial numbers photographed. So, unfortunately, I can't. But we will show you the curtains on another day, won't we, darling?
Yep. Look, that's the matchsticks with garlic and butter.
Right.
And then I'm just covering my clams in this gorgeous, beautiful.
Good.
Why do you think it's going to happen with that bread I made?
Remember, the new guys have just joined. If you want to be part of the gang, make sure you click on the share button.
Like and the share. It's the share.
Oh, yeah.
Can I try the sauce?
I'm on the sauce.
Do you
want to
try this sauce?
Oh. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, that is nice. Yummy.
Look at them bad boys though.
That's the fourth time they've been cooked?
Yeah.
What happened to pizza night? That was last night, Jamie. Did you miss it?
So parsley in. The leftover pizza, can you
Laura says, thank you, she's so chuffed.
How cool is that? You know what makes me feel that I've done something today? Not just for myself. Parsley, salt, pepper, white wine, fennel, leeks. I need a little bit more food. Tiny bit.
I've got something exciting as well for the guys tomorrow. I say the guys. It is for the guys, really, isn't it? Is it?
I think you're being sexist here.
All right, then. I've got something really exciting tomorrow, hopefully. And all going well. I've got something very exciting to share with you all.
Oh,
I can't wait.
Wow.
Right, come.
That's beautiful. But our octopus salad is ready.
Check out that. Look, my little gin tree. Thank you so much, Ian.
Thank you ever so much.
Ian makes those.
How about our neighbor? He maybe doesn't know she can mention live, but hey ho.
Which neighbor? Lauren?
Yep.
Yeah, well done, Lauren.
That's the community spirit.
I think I know Lauren's mum.
That's what's going to make us through.
Yeah, but 750,000 people have done the NHS voluntary.
My friend Marta did it as well.
Yeah, well, I wish I'd done it. I could have zoomed around delivering stuff.
We deliver stuff.
Well, we do it for our family, don't we?
Yeah. You know, charity starts at home,
they say. Yeah, but we could have done it for others as well. Would have got us out the house.
And mussels already. Mussels, sorry. Is them bad boys done? I'm happy with myself.
Are we there?
Yeah, we're done.
No way. This doesn't sound like instrumental music. It's gonna get out.
Alexa, play Brazilian jazz.
Instrumental jazz, darling.
Playing Brazilian jazz music on Amazon Music.
I'm just trying to sort out this camera because I've got two cameras going, haven't I?
Look, we have them. Yep, winey creamy sauce and the crispy garlicky matchsticks. Would you like that for dinner? Oh yes. I'm gonna add some fennel as well. I think you need to take a picture, babe. Oh yeah.
That was nearly expensive fall.
You almost...
Yeah, I nearly dropped two cameras. Right, darling, I've just got to dismount this camera. You've got to say goodbye to everyone on YouTube now, because I'm going to have to turn the YouTube off.
YouTube, guys?
No, hang on, no. Oh, now I've turned that camera around. Oh, I'm not... I'd sack the cameraman.
Right, that one. Say goodbye to this camera.
Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoy it, you need to subscribe to our channel and share it. Thank you.
Well done, darling. Right, and they are gone.